Okay, our first guest is a former child star turned Hollywood actress. She starred in the hit movie Mona Lisa Smile with Julia Roberts and had huge box office success alongside Matt Damon in the Bourne trilogies. She was also once the undisputed queen of teen flicks, starring in films like 10 Things I Hate About You, Hamlet, and this, Save the Last Dance. Please welcome Julia Stiles. Great to have you here. You were busting some moves there. And you really were pulling all the moves yourselves, weren't you? You refused to have a body double in that movie.
For the hip-hop stuff, yeah. For the ballet, I couldn't go on point, so the point shoes were doubled. But the rest of it, yeah, I got some soul in me.
Wow. Did you have to learn that for the film, or did you have a little bit of lino at home that you used to just break dance on?
No, we did a lot of choreography and training. I did about maybe a month of training just for the ballet before the movie started, and, you know, all the hip-hop stuff was more, like, in my soul.
Well, your soul is under question in your latest role because you've joined the cast of Dexter.
Oh, yes.
And you're not a goodie, are you?
Well, she's not. It's so tricky talking about the show because there's so much that they love to keep secret. But the when my character is first introduced, she's been through a major trauma, and so anything that she does that is morally questionable later is to overcome that trauma. And I'll leave it at
you
that.
Have to, as a huge fan, may I say, of Dexter, and I'm so thrilled that you're in it. I can understand this. Anybody who, you know, because you are a goodie in my book if you join Dexter, because he has his good moments, doesn't he? That's why it's so hard. He is a serial killer, but it's kind of good that he is.
Oh, yeah.
You are a serial killer.
Yeah, but he's a good one.
He kills the baddies. Who deserve it?
Vigilante justice.
Exactly. Yes.
Well, Linda is beside herself with excitement at the thought of a new series. So here's a little peek at just how you make your debut in episode 3, I believe.
What do you think?
You look...
I look stupid, don't I?
No.
You can tell me the truth. Really? Look at those. Yeah.
So are you guys, you know, getting it on?
Or... That is actually a much later episode.
Okay.
You know, when Dexter and my character's name is Lumen, when they first meet, they're actually really at odds with each other, and they have to kind of... I mean, he effectively saves her, but they both have secrets about each other, and so there's actually a lot of conflict, and then because of the weird circumstances of their relationship, it progresses.
It looks like there's chemistry.
What's
happened to his wife?
Well, in season 4, at the very end, and I don't think this is a spoiler because it's already aired, that she...
Have we? You've had it?
I don't think we have we?
Maybe we shouldn't say. It's like talking about...
Well, there's a big clue.
Tell us about the Bourne films. They're wonderful.
Oh, thanks. Yeah, they're really fun to work on.
Will you be making more of those?
They are making another one, but they're sort of doing what, I guess, happened with James Bond, where a new actor has the Bourne identity.
Oh, no. Not Matt Damon.
Yeah,
no, that's not going to work.
No. I'm not the first person to reveal this.
Is he still in it?
Matt Damon's not going to be in it.
No.
I think it's Jeremy Renner is going to be the new Bourne.
Not interested.
From the Hurt Locker.
Oh, and his arms, because Matt Damon's got really good arms. How are the new guys' arms?
Well, I think...
it's important.
I think that in order to become an actor, you have to automatically have good arms.
Good arms.
So they all have good arms.
That's good. I like that.
Yes.
Can you believe it is 12 years since you appeared in 10 Things I Hate About You?
Wow.
12 years.
Really?
Alongside Heath Ledger.
What have I been doing with my life?
Exactly. was that a defining role for you, a defining moment in your life? Because it was your big break, really, wasn't it?
Yeah, it was. I mean, I heard before when I was introduced being called a child actor, I don't really consider myself a child actress because I didn't start working regularly in movies until I was 17 or 18. I mean, 10 Things I Hate About You was my first big role, and I was 17 when we shot it. It came out when I was 18. I mean, and that's young, but I had a normal childhood.
Okay.
And you got into it quite by chance, didn't you, acting?
Yeah. I worked with a theatre company in New York that did a lot of sort of fringe theatre just for fun. And that was all through high school. But then they helped me find an agent, and I just really loved it. And I never really thought of it as like a career, because I don't think you think that way when you're a teenager. But then eventually I realized that I could make some money.
But you didn't have a clue what you wanted to do before?
Well, I was always sort of, my mom's an artist, and I grew up in Soho in New York, which is a very sort of bohemian neighborhood, or it was. And the idea of doing something creative and certainly something in the performing arts was always, was always on my mind.
Were you quite a performer-y child?
Were
you like tap dancing in the house and that sort of thing?
A show off.
I was a bit like that.
In an annoying way. But I think living in New York City as a child, you don't have a backyard, so the only thing that I could do was like figure out a way to entertain myself in front of the TV. You know, I would act out what I saw on TV a lot. So, I couldn't really go outside and play. It was all indoors.
Mm. Now, Dexter is back on our screens on the 17th of June here on the FX channel. We know you've shot one series. Will you be back for another?
They're shooting season 6 right now, and I was just...
You're here. That doesn't bode well.
And I'm here. It's true. But, you know, if I answered that, then that would reveal what happens to... what the fate of my character is at the very end. Because usually people end up dead. So
yeah, well, he kills everyone. That's his job.
Right, exactly.
Yeah. Oh, well, thank you so much for coming by today.
It's my pleasure.
And please keep up your incredible work. Julia Stiles, everyone.